So our special guest this evening is an O. Henry Award-winning novelist, screenwriter, short story writer, and an icon of independent film. He's directed 18 films, including Return of the Sea Caucus 7, which I'm sure many of you caught earlier today at the festival, as well as Matewan, Lone Star, and Passion Fish, for which he received an Academy Award nomination for Best Original Screenplay. His primary profession is working as a screenwriter in a variety of genres, from westerns to monster flicks, beginning his career working with legendary director-producer Roger Corman, who many of you have probably heard of, writing screenplays for Piranha, Battle Beyond the Stars, and The Lady in Red. So without further ado, I'm completely thrilled to welcome to the stage John Sayles.
Hi, everybody. And remember, if you're only passively eating and drinking, you have to keep your mask on. So welcome to Invaders from Mars, which is a movie that taught my generation not to trust our parents or any other authority figures. We have a special guest tonight, Jimmy Hunt, who is the star of the movie. He has recovered from being in this movie, which was, I'm sure, really tough for any actor. This is a movie that I saw in black and white on TV when I was 8 years old, and it really freaked me out, as it did a lot of young kids at the time. Kids who grew up under the shadow of the atom bomb, even if you were little, you kind of felt that in the air. It's reflected in a lot of the science fiction movies of the time. And this was directed by William Cameron Menzies, who was a guy who incredibly talented guy. This was toward the end of his career. He was much better known and had much more success as a production designer. In fact, he's probably the first person who got the credit production designer on Gone with the Wind. He was kind of way ahead of his time. If he didn't invent storyboarding, he popularized it. He worked on films such as Thief of Baghdad, Things to Come, Nothing Sacred, Gone with the Wind, King's Row, For Whom the Bell Tolls, as a designer, sometimes as a director. And he started as an illustrator, and I think it's really interesting to look at his work as a production designer and as a director with that in mind. There's a long kind of interplay between the great illustrators of America and the movies. So if you think of illustrators like Howard Pyle, N.C. Wyeth, Frederick Remington, those are the people who taught the movies what pirates and cowboys were supposed to look like. This is a movie, as you'll see, that is very reminiscent of the covers of pulp science fiction and horror magazines like Amazing Stories. The posters for this movie, of course, have some, you know, alien creature with a woman who has passed out carrying her around. That classic look. And this was like a 3.5 week shoot. Very, very low budget. William Cameron Menzies and his cinematographer, John Seitz, who was no slouch, a guy who shot This Gun for Hire, Sullivan's Travels, Sunset Boulevard, Double Indemnity. This was a job that they said, we're going to do our best job we can do in 3.5 weeks with no money. And they did a pretty great job. There are some, kind of, the most interesting thing about this movie, and what was upsetting to me as a kid, is it didn't look like most movies. There's a lot of kind of German expressionist angles in it. There are sets that are very unrealistic in a way, but really kind of emotionally disturbing. And I think what William Cameron Menzies did is he looked at this script and he said, I'm going to tell it through the point of view of this little kid David that Jimmy Hunt plays. This is how he would imagine this thing. So there's a lot of dream imagery in it, comic book angles. And there's also, you will notice, quite a bit of stock footage of Army equipment moving around. And most of that was added by the producer later on to make the thing long enough to seem like a feature. And some of it is not, you know, it's supposed to be gearing up to fight the aliens, and it's just trucks moving around. So there are a few things that the director was not responsible for. So welcome to the funky, low-budget classic of paranoia, Invaders from Mars.